إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره نعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما أما بعد فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله خير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها فإن كل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار وإنما توعدون لآت وما أنتم بمعجزين. Praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and He is the only one worthy of praise. I seek His help, His guidance and His forgiveness. I believe in Him and I trust Him. I seek refuge in Almighty Allah from the evil of our passions. Indeed, whomsoever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guides him to Islam, no one can mislead him after Allah. And whomsoever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put him astray, no one can guide him after Allah. I testify openly that there is no deity worthy of worship except Allah Rabbil Alameen. And I testify that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is his messenger and the seal of all the prophets. O Muslims, you must know that the best speech is the speech of Almighty Allah, which is the Quran. The best guidance is the course of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, which is his sunnah. The worst of all affairs is innovation and addition to the religion of Islam. Indeed, every addition to the religion of Islam will lead to hellfire. I adjure you as well as myself to fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to the best of your ability. Fear Allah, have the taqwa of Allah, and don't die unless you are in a state of Islam. After this, I greet you all with the greeting of Islam. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. May the peace and the blessing of Almighty Allah be with you all. I'd like to thank all of you for being here tonight. Although I know it's snow, name it, all kind of things, hardship, difficulty. I know most of you doesn't have four wheels drive and all these things, but you took a chance to be here tonight. And like I stated before, that most of you would know already the things that I'm teaching here. But for being here, dedicating some time, taking time out of your busy schedule and to be in the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you be rewarded. And one of the most important things that we need to revive the mission of the mosque, the mission of the mosque of the teaching. The mission of the mosque is that to be visited. The mission of the mosque is that the Muslims get to see each other and meet with each other. And these things became missing in our life. So if we make this effort, inshallah, that once a week that we'll come together, for even if you are not coming to get the knowledge because you already have the knowledge, being sitting in the mosque, waiting for the next prayer, you get in the dua of the angels. As the Prophet ﷺ had told us, that when you sit in the mosque while you have a wudu waiting for the next prayer, that the angels make a dua for you saying, Allahumma afrullah, Allahumma arham, O Allah forgive him, O Allah send mercy on him. So by coming and spending 1 hour a week here, you never can be a loser, believe me, and I swear on it. You never can be a loser spending 1 hour a week in the mosque. Even if you know the information, you are not going to be a loser. Let's not to waste our time in introduction, come direct to the subject. And I know we have a new faces tonight. We had lesson one last week, so those who would not hear and did not have a copy, I have extra copies here. Okay, about Ad-Dars Al-Awwal. Anybody know what is Ad-Dars Al-Awwal? Ad-Dars Al-Awwal means what? Yes? Exactly. Thank you. Anybody have, need a copy? Anybody? Those who forgot their copies, please don't take a copy. Give one to Sister Zahida, please, okay? And if you have a copy, please try to share it with the person beside you. A few copies here. Okay, anybody? Well, you can sit with Jay, both of you together, and right hand, please. Right hand, thank you. Okay, this is the sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, that you take with the right hand, okay? Okay, so maybe Brother Habib is going to make copies for us, inshallah. Anybody need copy? Oh, we have two copies here already. All right. All right, we're going to go over the first first line, first lesson, inshallah. Anybody need a copy? Anybody? This is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. What do you have? Yeah, you need a copy?
No.
Is this your copy now? Okay, we need 5 copies more, please. 5 copies more, Brother Habib. Take a copy with you to make it. All right, the first lesson was about learning the Ism al-Ishara Hada, which means what? Anybody know? Hada means what?
This,
exactly, okay? If you point to something, okay, that is close to you, you say Hada. Hada means what? This, okay? And we are in the house of Allah, is it? We are in the masjid, which what? Is the house of Allah. So how you say the house of Allah? Can somebody tell me what does house mean? The house of Allah. Okay, but don't look in the paper. Look at me. Bayt. So the word bayt, this is general, anything, any house, fancy house, a small house, you call it bayt. You know why it's bayt? Call bayt? Because you make what? Mabit in it. You see? So that means you spend the night, this is where you go and you sleep there. This is called bayt for mabit, okay? Bayt ayabitu, okay? So baytullah means what?
House of Allah.
The house of Allah. And the Kaaba is what? Baytullah. The Kaaba is baytullah, okay? And this is what? Baytullah. Okay, how you say my house? My house. Bayti. Bayti. Give you a very small trick, okay, or make things easy on you. Anything in Arabic you want to say is mine, add ya in the end. Okay? So sa'a will be what? Sa'ati. Okay? Nazara, nazarati. Bayt, bayti. Qalam, qalami. What is qalam? Qalami. So how you say my pen? Qalami. So we took the word what? Bayt. Bayt means what?
House.
Okay. Did we take the word key? Key. What is key? Miftah. Miftah. How you say my key? I think sisters need 3 copies in the back. How you say? Miftah means what? Key. A key for the car, a key for the house, anything. Alright, you say what? Miftah. 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 Alright, how you say my key? Miftahi. Zawj. Zawji. Okay? Akh means brother. Akhi. Alright, so let's focus here on what we have. We have the word, what's this? This exit, what you call?
Bab.
What's this? Bab. Bab. How you say my door? Babi. Okay, anything you add yeah to it, it will be my. Doesn't matter if you are a male or female, okay? You add yeah and the sound E will give you the position of mine, okay? Let's go over the words that we took last week, okay? Hada bayti. Say it.
Hada bayti.
هذا بيت.
هذا
بيت.
هذا بيت.
هذا مسجد.
هذا مسجد.
هذا مسجد.
هذا مسجد.
How you can say my mosque?
مسجدي.
Okay. هذا باب. This is a door. What you say? هذا باب. هذا باب. Next word. What's this?
كتاب.
كتاب. How you say my book? كتاب. B. B. E. This E will bring the position. I own this. Okay? Alright. كتابي. The word قلم. هذا قلم. Say هذا قلم.
هذا قلم.
هذا قلم.
هذا قلم.
Pin. Okay. مفتاح.
مفتاح.
هذا مفتاح.
هذا مفتاح.
هذا بيت.
هذا بيت.
هذا مسجد.
هذا مسجد.
هذا باب.
هذا باب.
هذا كتاب.
هذا كتاب.
What's هذا mean?
This.
Okay. هذا قلم.
هذا قلم.
هذا مفتاح.
هذا مفتاح.
I'm sure you already all know these words, so today we're going to add only three words. Because I know some of you could not understand, memorize this and this and that, so I'm going to give you a break tonight, okay? Maktab.
هذا
مكتب.
هذا
مكتب.
هذا
مكتب.
هذا مكتب.
I can call this is مكتب, okay? A desk. Table, whatever that you understand, use it, you call it maktab, alright? هذا maktab.
هذا maktab.
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 Sarir.
Sarir.
Sarir. What is sarir?
Bed.
Bed. How you say my bed?
Sarir.
Sariri. Sariri. Okay? Kursi.
كرسي.
هذا كرسي.
هذا كرسي.
Chair. هذا كرسي.
هذا كرسي.
مكتب.
مكتب.
سرير.
سرير.
كرسي.
كرسي.
مكتب.
مكتب.
سرير.
سرير.
كرسي.
كرسي.
هذا مكتب.
هذا مكتب.
هذا مكتب.
هذا مكتب.
هذا سرير.
هذا
كرسي.
هذا كرسي.
I say the word in Arabic and you tell me the English. مفتاح. Now I want to see who's going to be the first one to say it. Don't look in the paper now. Okay. باب. Good. Okay. كتاب. Thank you. مسجد.
مسجد.
Okay. باب. كرسي. Give me a verse from the Quran. All of you know it. That has the word كرسي. واسع كرسيه السماوات والأرض. كرسي. بيت. قلم. مفتاح. مكتب. مكتب.
Table.
Desk. You can call also the office مكتب. Okay? Yeah. Not library.
No.
Library will be مكتبة. مكتبة. Yes. مكتبة. كرسي. Okay. We're going to say these words one time with each other. This is your lesson for today. The three new words. So please, inshallah, when you come next week, you should know 9 words. Plus, you know now one thing new, that when you add ya to the noun, it will make it a position, my.
How about this kursi? Because kursi already have the
Has the ya to give it another ya.
Kursi.
My kursi. Kursi.
Kursi.
Kursi. Will be ya. Yeah, okay. Kursi. No, you don't say my kursi. Kursi, kursiyi. Hada kursiyi, okay? Yes, alright. Hada bayti, hada masjidi, hada babi, hada kitab. Any question about the Arabic lesson for today? Any question? Any question? Everybody have a copy? Please make sure that you study, inshallah. Thank you. Okay, we go to the second session about dua and dhikr. Dua, where is dua? Not here. And dhikr, inshallah, dhikr is not here. Okay, we had started dua al-istikhara. Dua what? Al-istikhara. Anybody doesn't forget their copy? Okay, only new people. Alright, this is one, two. No. If you got a copy before, you could not get a copy again. Okay, alright. Jazakallah khair. You knew? You didn't come last week? Okay, this is cost $10,000. Okay, give this to the sisters in the back, please. This is more than $10,000. The importance of this dua is more than money, okay? You can go invest not $10,000, $100,000. And after this, he found that was not a real business, that somebody made a fraud, that you work for 2 years and after this it didn't work, you have to sell it, you lost money. So this is the right approach, okay? Some people, they go for what you call business consultation, and they charge you for hour, whatever it is, give you some reports that in 1995 it's made such a $500,000, and you understand? But this is what happened. You don't know what's going to happen. People give you results about what happened, okay, report about happened, but nobody can tell you what's going to happen. They can assume it, but does not have to work. So this is more than $10,000 in your hand. A consultation, you're consulting Allah, asking Allah guidance. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam had give us this beautiful gift, and we should be grateful, learn it. Somebody told me that was too much to memorize the 3 lines. Okay, I understand some of you work very hard, and maybe you did not have the time to study and to memorize. At least try to make sure that you know how to really try it. Somebody took my copy? Okay. So I think they tried to see if I know it by heart or no. Come on guys, why you do this to me? Who took my copy?
Just hold.
Is that correct? Only borrow it, eh?
Yes.
Okay.
It costs $100,000.
Okay, but how am I going to read it? Just scratch.
That's the Engelbeck.
So, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam telling us that before you go, approach something and you don't know what the proper way, okay, you're debating it, you don't know, say, make 2 rak'at, and after this, turn to Allah in dua, with the special dua. And you know that we don't get any fabricated hadith here, okay? Counterfeit, no. Every hadith, inshallah, is taught in this mosque that is authentic. Okay? So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam taught us this dua, that after you make the 2 rak'at, you will say it. And you ask Allah to guide you. If you could not memorize the 3 lines, and we're going to add 2 more today, by next week, it's fine with me, but at least try to make sure you know how to say it right. If some business comes, if it's a marriage proposal comes, or a new job, or whatever it is comes, you understand? I see people start and they like the second proposal. Okay? Take the dua, take this piece of paper and say it. Say it. Do not approach major things like this. You don't know about it. Okay? Before you say the dua. Now, after this, go ahead. Don't worry. Whatever going to happen, let it happen. Because you already consulted with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Jazakallah khair. Ing bangolando. Thank you. Jazakallah khair. Anybody without a copy? Okay. Arwa Marwa, you already had one last week, is it? Okay. Best ones here, Habib, please. Alright, I'm going to go over the first 3 lines that we already made last week. Alright? My voice is too loud, is it? Okay. Is it better now?
Not at all.
No? Khalaj. Orange beer, brother. Okay, is it better now?
Yes.
All right. I found a trick to do it. All right, we're going to say the first three lines that we already have them last week, and after this we're going to add two lines, inshallah. Allahumma.
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 Inni.
Inni.
Allahumma inni.
Allahumma inni.
Astaghfiruka.
أستخيرك
بعلمك
بعلمك
وأستقدرك وأستقدرك بقدرتك. Do you have extra copy, Habib? The support doesn't have
one, two, three.
Get three more, brother, as we can. You can get up to four. وأستقدرك بقدرتك وأستقدرك بقدرتك وأسألك
وأسألك
من فضلك
من فضلك
العظيم
العظيم.
By the way, you understand when you ask somebody and you say excuse me or would you please say من فضلك, okay? So you can remember this word that you can start to use some Arabic terminology, okay? Instead of excuse me, may I have the understand? You said من فضلك, okay? Or min fadlik, okay? وأسألك من فضلك العظيم وأسألك من فضلك العظيم فإنك تقدر فإنك تقدر ولا أقدر أقدر ولا أقدر وتعلم وتعلم ولا أعلم ولا أعلم وتعلم ولا أعلم وأنت علام الغيوب علام الغيوب
علام الغيوب.
What is Allah's name? علام الغيوب. هو العليم عالم. Okay, العليم علام الغيوب. Do you know what is علام الغيوب mean? علام the one who is the most knowledgeable. Okay, الغيوب is the unseen. So when you say Allah علام الغيوب, that means Allah is what? The knower of the unseen, ghuyub, okay? Something that is hidden, something you could not see it. Especially the future, okay? Especially the future, okay? All right, this is what we studied last week. All right? Can we add a little bit to it? We're going to go fast to quick again about what we studied last week. All right? Instead, word by word, we say, Allahumma. إني أستخيرك بعلمك وأستقدرك بقدرتك وأسألك من فضلك العظيم فإنك تقدر ولا أقدر وتعلم ولا أعلم وأنت علام الغيوب. Okay, the new lines for today. Allahumma.
Allahumma.
اللهم
اللهم
إن كنت
إن كنت
إن كنت
إن كنت
تعلم
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 أن
أن
هذا الأمر
هذا الأمر
خير لي
خير لي
خير لي
خير لي
في ديني
في ديني
في ديني
في ديني
ومعاشي
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 وعاقبتي
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 أمري
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 again
اللهم
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 إن كنت
إن كنت
إن كنت
إن كنت
تعلم
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 أن
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 هذا الأمر
هذا الأمر
خير لي
خير لي
خير لي
خير لي
في ديني
في ديني
في ديني
في ديني
ومعاشي
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 وعاقبتي
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 أمري
أمري
okay I'm not going to give you any more so you can encouraged to study is only one line and a half. Look now. You say, Allahumma, O Allah. You found the English in the other side. So you can, as example, in top of Allahumma, you can put number 15 as example. And you go to the word in English to match it. You put 15 there. Okay, like this. Allahumma means what? O Allah. You say, Ya Allah. So you call in Allah. Say, Allahumma. In if kunta are ta'lamu know anna that hadha you already took hadha is it this okay you see when you get more vocabulary now you're going to will be easy to understand Quran and hadith hadha means that this. Al-amra means affair. Khair or khairun means what? Good. Okay? Something good. Khair. Say such a such a such a thing happen. You say what? You say khair. That means good, inshallah. Okay? Khairun li means for me. For me, li, fi, in, din, ni, din means what? Religion, din, din al-Islam, dini, my religion, wa ma'ashi, ma'ashi, my livelihood, wa aqibati, Amri, and the final of my affair. Affair means Amr. Amr. Amri, my affair. You see? You remember they say Kitab, Kitabi? Mm-hmm. So you found this word what? Amri. Amr means affair. Amri, my affair. Wa aqibati Amri, okay, was going to happen later on. Okay. So this is part of the dua that we learned. The whole thing is one dua. Okay? But I'm giving it to you piece by piece so you can learn it. So now when you reach the word أن هذا الأمر okay, you will say buy this car Cadillac, you understand 2015 or whatever, alright? Or buy this house or marrying this sister, or going for this interview. You will name what you want to do, okay? Alright? You did not say, هذا الأمر, and leave. No, you say, O Allah, Allahumma in kunta ta'lam anna ذهابي إلى مصر في هذا الوقت خير لي في ديني ودنيا عاجل أمر وعاجله. Okay, so you say you will name your affair that you about to embark or to do it. Okay, you will name it here in this place. Okay. Oh Allah, if you know that such a thing, okay, you're going to name it, is good for me in my religion, in my livelihood, and my future, okay? Now, this is what you will say. فَقْدُرْهُ لِي وَيَسِّرْهُ لِي. We're going to talk about it next time. Anybody understand anything? Okay. Yes.
Brother, you said we have to say some dua, then we can say something which we want.
Yeah, this is a dua. But when you reach it to this word,
which word?
After هذا, الأمر, the word instead of هذا الأمر, okay.
اللهم إن كنت تعلم
أن, okay. اللهم إن كنت تعلم أن.
أن.
And now you're going to say what? My traveling to Pakistan.
Uh-huh.
Or marrying sister so and so. Or I understand changing this office to whatever, different business. You will name what you're planning to do, what you want to do. And after this, you will continue again and say, خير لي. So instead of هذا الأمر, instead of saying the word هذا الأمر, this affair, you will name what you want to do.
After Anna will be the affair, and when I finish the affair, then
you will say, خير لي, okay, في ديني ومعاشي وعاقبة أمري. So, oh Allah, if you know, leaving the mosque of Columbia, South Carolina, and going to Detroit, Michigan, be the imam there, and making, you understand, $7,000 every month, instead of, you understand, could not find even two, okay? And you will find 100 people in the class and all this. Oh Allah, if you know that me going, being the imam in Detroit, leave Columbia, South Carolina, okay, is khairuli. So now you have to name the affair. And now you continue in saying the word, خير لي, is good for me. In my life, in my dunya, in my deen, in my future. So make it to be so.
Like I don't know Arabic, so I can say in my language too, or it has to be in Arabic?
Yes, inshallah. Because you never know what is the affair that I could not. I teach you about a car, next thing you said, oh, it was not a car, it was a sister. I teach you about a sister, I said, no, it was not a sister, it was buying a house. So, inshallah, the mercy of Allah is good if you don't. لا يكلف الله نفسا إلا وسعها. And Allah knows what He's saying. But we, اتقوا الله ما استطعتم. This is the ruling in Islam. اتقوا الله ما استطعتم. That means, practice this deen to the best of your ability. So we asking you to learn the dua, but if it's not your language and you don't know, now you're going to say, oh Allah, in هذا الأمر, okay, traveling to Pakistan or getting you understand this business, whatever, now you go back to the Arabic and say it. Okay? It key, it have to be there. It's not because you have a key, you can open with this key the car and open the house and open the liberty, what you call this, the safe deposit, and okay? So Islam made a key for everything, and this is the key for future consultation about doing something. It's very important. It's very important. So when you come to this place that you don't know what it is, say it in your own language. But make sure you don't say it in Urdu. All right, let's stop here.
A question.
Yes.
When it gets to awqal ajil amri or ajili,
is a taraddud min al rawi. The reporter of the hadith, he was not sure if this is what been said.
Yes.
And this will show you how honest are the Sahaba. If he forgot a word, he will say, did the Prophet say this or that? Mm-hmm. So he reported both of them.
Yes. But the question is, we can just leave that out. We can choose, in other words, what we say.
You can choose or you can say both.
Right.
Inshallah. So to be sure that you got it right.
Yes.
Yes. Inshallah. Jazakallah khair. All right, we finished the dua session. Yes. Yes, ma'am.
So,
we have only 10 minutes. Go ahead.
So you say the dua after you make
Sunnah? Yes, you have to be two Sunnah. Not you understand, go pray Fajr. two rak'at and after this he made the dua. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said to pray two rak'at ghayr al-farida, that you make two rak'at optional, voluntarily, not obligatory. You're going to make wudu, if it's the qibla, you make two rak'at, like any two rak'at, okay? And after this he will say the dua. Any question? Alright. We go to our favorite subject. I think we talk about my favorite subject is what? Bid'ah Buster. Okay? So, this is not your favorite. But anyway, we talk about what? Wudu and purification last week?
No, it was about Bid'ah and Azan.
In Adhan, okay. So, would you like to go according to the order that I'm writing? We can have bid'ah about Salah today, or bid'ah about Jum'ah, or we already made the Quran. And those who missed the one about Quran, you need to go to YouTube and watch it.
Like, what's the name of the link so we can go and...
YouTube / user / Muhammad Adli, MUHAMMAD. You have my medical record there, you can copy my name from it. Okay, or we can talk about bid'ah of Ramadan and fasting, bid'ah about Hajj and Umrah, bid'ah about Eid. Okay, which one? Because we don't have too much time.
Juma.
Okay, let's see what's going on in Juma. Okay, yeah. We take Jum'ah because it's short and we don't have too much time. Okay, bid'ah al-Jum'ah. Innovation related to Jum'ah. Number one, qira'at al-Quran bi sawtin murtafi' qabla al-khutbah. Okay? Recitation of the Quran with a loud voice. Okay? Surah al-Kahf inside the mosque. I know you have different countries and different backgrounds, but as example, in Egypt, there is a special chair sitting in the middle of the mosque. And the Qari, the Hafiz, will come like half an hour before Jum'ah, before the khutbah. And he will sit there with the loudspeaker and start singing, you understand, Surah Kahf, Surah Yasin, whatever surah. And the purpose say because most of the people illiterate, they don't know Quran. So if he leaves them, they're going to be speaking and making noise and things like this. So we occupy them by reciting Quran. So somebody came to this kind of conclusion and started this kind of bid'ah. But you disturbing the people who just come into the mosque. Because when you come to the mosque, you're supposed to do what? Two rak'at before you sit down. At least two rak'at. Alright? Nevertheless, if it's something... Is not something been done by the Prophet or the Khulafa al-Rashidin or Umar or Abu Bakr or any of them. In the time of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, was no recitation of the Quran with a loud voice in the mosque at any time. At any time. It's time for Salah and Salah unless there is a class that to teach people Quran. Okay, this is a different story. Okay? But this man would sit there every Jum'ah. And people, most of the people, the children grow up and became men, they think that this is part of the deen. And this is part of the tradition of Jum'ah, reciting the Quran with a loud voice, you understand, a mukri or a hafiz will come and recite the Quran. So this is bid'ah, and it shouldn't be. And somebody said, but brother, this is Quran, it's something good. I say, if it's something good, the Quran is good, but the act is not good. Why, brother? He's not dancing. He's not a belly dancer. This is a man saying Quran. I say, yeah, because you saying, if this is good, why the Prophet didn't do it? So now you claim you know more than the Prophet. Because the Prophet taught us everything that is good and forbade us from everything that is bad. Okay? So recitation of the Quran with a loud voice in the mosque in Yawm al-Jum'ah. Okay. Number two. I hope I didn't make this already. I have to go check in YouTube. But anyway, even if I said it, I'll beat it again. Number two, making two adhan for Jum'ah inside the mosque. Making two adhan for Jum'ah inside the mosque. Well, it seems that I did it.
Yeah, for sure.
Where?
Last Tuesday.
Yeah.
The bid'ah for the adhan, yeah.
Okay, I'm sorry, guys. All right, we'll change. Let's talk about bid'ah for salah. Okay? Good. Number one, al-jahru bin niyyah. Somebody come, say the intention out loud. Nawaitu usalli fard al-zuhr. Fardan lillah alayhim wa tamman bi'adha al-imam al-shafi' al-madhab. Arba rak'at. Allahu Akbar. People before they make salah, they make their intention out loud. Who you talking to? Allah knows what you. Allah knows. He understand where you going, where you pray, what going to pray, what you surah you going even to read before he say. Who you telling? You know that you're going to make dhuhr, and Allah knows that you're going to make dhuhr. So who you telling? Why you talking?
Show off.
Whatever it is, but intention is in the heart. Saying it verbally is bid'ah. And some people, they say the whole 9 yards. That means what? I intend to make the obligatory prayer, zuhr, 4 rak'at, follow the imam who is the Maliki Madhab school. I nawaitu Allahu Akbar. Okay? This is wrong. And this is bid'ah. Number three. Oh, no. Number two. رفع الصوت بالتكبير عند دخول الصلاة وعند الانتقال. Raising the voice for the followers. Raising the followers. Raising their voice, Hanan. Okay? Raising their voices behind the imam. Entering the salah, starting the salah. Or, Rabbana wa laka alhamd. Or, As-salamu alaykum. You found the whole masjid. As-salamu alaykum rahmatullah. As-salamu alaykum rahmatullah. Okay? All action, all saying of the follower behind the imam is what? Amen. To himself. Exception of what? Ameen. This is the only thing that we inherited from the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and been practiced by the Sahaba is to say out loud, Ameen. Other than this, everything you say to yourself. Everything you say to yourself. The imam says, Sami Allahu liman hamida, or Allahu Akbar, he comes from sujood. So, there is a purpose for him to say it loud. So you can know that the imam got up, as example. But you, who are you making it loud? You are not supposed to say anything loud in your prayer behind the imam, unless you are the imam. Number three.
Astaghfirullah at the end.
Astaghfirullah where?
At the end of the prayer.
We didn't start the prayer yet.
But if you say it, if you say it out loud.
Astaghfirullah?
Yeah.
Okay. You're supposed to say...
Three times.
Okay, I'm going to come to it.
Okay.
Is number nine.
Okay.
Okay, number three. Believing that you could not pray in anything other than prayer rug. This is bid'ah. Okay? There is nothing called prayer rug. You can pray at anything. You can pray on the grass. You can pray on the sand. The mosque of the Prophet ﷺ does not even have a carpet. Sometimes they have a mat or something, okay? But for you to think that you have to have a prayer rug, okay, for the salah, this is not acceptable, all right? This is a bid'ah. It's a big business now. People are China making money out of the Muslims, okay? All right. Number four, decorating so-called the prayer rug. Even if there is a prayer rug or a mat, is supposed to be solid. Like you see this carpet here? You are not supposed to have anything that decorated different colors because all the things is taking your attention and distraction to you. One day the Prophet ﷺ, he have a striped soap, okay? And when he finishes salah, he took it off and say, take it to so and so because it disturbed me in my prayer. Okay? So, the prayer rug, if there is a prayer rug that you use. Some people, they did not distinguish between something dirty and something impure. Say, brother, this is dirty, brother. You don't see all this dirt is there? There is nothing wrong with the dirt. The Prophet ﷺ even praying in his mosque, and was raining, so the dirt became like a mud. And when got up, he understands he can see the impact of the mud in his forehead. But he prays there. So some Muslims think it have to be. And you, even you go to some people with big, mashallah, fancy houses, mansion. And when they make the ikama, say, wait, brother. And they go, give everybody a prayer rug. Okay, so what's wrong with it? No. Okay, number 5. رفع اليدين بعد الركوع كما في حالة الدعاء. The Imam said, سمع الله لمن حمده, he said, ربنا ولك الحمد. And okay, raise the hand as if he's making dua. This is not. In the proper way is to raise your hand like this facing the Qibla. Alright? But the people, سمع الله لمن حمده. And some of them even make their face like this. And there is a warning, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, this is mixed between mid'ah and mistake. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam warned the people that raise their face like this to the sky, that they have to stop or otherwise Allah will snatch their sight. Allah will snatch away their sight. Okay, so this is very, you are not supposed to raise your head, and neither you make your hands like this after the ruku'. After number 6, ziyadat lafz al-shukr ba'd qawli sami'a Allah liman hamida. Okay, some people say, when the Imam says sami'a Allah liman hamida, say Rabbana wa laka alhamd wa shukr. This never been in any hadith, neither uttered by the Prophet or the Sahaba. Say that all praise and thanks to Allah, shukr, is not correct. Number 7, saying Sayyidina fi al-tashahud. قبل قول عند قول اللهم صل على محمد, they say اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد. When you sit and make تشهد, you are not supposed to say the word سيدنا, our master, okay? Because the salah is glorifying and magnifying Allah. You are not supposed to magnify anybody else in the salah, okay? You send in peace and blessing on the Prophet Muhammad, you say أشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. He's a slave and his messenger. But some people, they said, what Sayyidina before they say Muhammad in the tashahud. This is wrong. And this is an innovation. Number 8. Turning, flipping the right hand when you say Assalamu alaikum rahmatullah. Doing the right hand like this. Assalamu alaikum rahmatullah. Flipping the left hand to the left side. This is also a bid'ah. When they finish. Okay. Number 9. مصافحة المصلين بعضهم البعض بعد الصلاة. Make giving salam, shaking hand to the person in your right, shaking hand with the person in your left. Okay, and somebody said, brother, what's wrong? We understand is salam is something good. You understand? Salam, you when you enter the mosque, you can say assalamu alaikum. You meet the same person in the shoe area and you talk for 15 minutes. Okay, after salah, why are you shaking hand again? So what's wrong, brother? Is good to make Allah love salah. Is Allah, but who, if something good, why the Prophet didn't teach us? Why the Sahaba did not practice it? If you are not going to make the Prophet to be your Imam and the Sahaba to be your guidance, you going astray. We have only one Imam, and this is the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So there is no shaking hand after the salah. And some people understand, they believe and they think that this the sunnah. Because they see a lot of masajid doing this. Okay? This also is bid'ah. Number 10. قول المصلين لبعضهم لبعض بعد الصلاة حرما. And the people say what to each other also? They say حرما. That means that you will make the prayer in the haram. And the other one will say to him what? جمعاً. He say together. Okay? So, and this is something special, you understand, you go to some Islamic country, you found the whole mosque, and this became like a tradition, and the children grow in this culture, and they will think that this is part of the sunnah. Shaking hand right, shaking hand, say haraman, he say to you, say jam'an, haraman, he say jam'an, okay? Number 11, and I'm sure most of us are going to relate to this, or to the one after this. ختم الصلاة بصورة جماعية. The Imam will lead the dhikr after the salah, okay, and the people will follow him. Wa bihamdihi subhanallah. Everybody subhanallah, subhanallah, subhanallah. Wa bihamdihi hamdan kathiran tayyiban. Alhamdulillah. Everybody started to say alhamdulillah, alhamdulillah. Maybe the imam is faster and he did 33, but somebody understands slow because his back hurting him. Say alhamdulillah, alhamdulillah, like this. So the imam jumped to the next, he put it in the second gear. So now you have to put your car in the second gear. And now you have to go to alhamdulillah, Allahu Akbar, Kabir, Allahu Akbar. You drop alhamdulillah, and now you go to Allahu Akbar. Okay? So leading, like he leads them in salah, he leads them in zikr. Now listen to number 12. Ad-du'a after every salah, collectively or individually. Okay? Some people, they believe or they practice the du'a collectively. The imam will lead them after the salah in du'a. And they will sit waiting for the imam. And I know that some imams, they understand they've been fired because he doesn't practice this bid'ah. Because the people, this part of their culture or some of their school or whatever it is, and they said that they don't, because this is so important to them, almost equal to the salah itself, that the imam have to lead them. So if you have a need, ask Allah yourself, why are you waiting for the imam, you understand, to lead you in the dua. So dua after every salah is not a sunnah. Not as individually, neither as collectively. Number 13. Also from the bid'ah, wiping the face, okay, after the dua. What did you ask me about astaghfirullah?
Okay. After salah.
Yeah. Saying astaghfirullah, okay.
Three times.
Wiping the face after the dua is a weak hadith, is not acceptable. Alright? What does it mean? Okay? There is no authentic hadith about the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam used to wipe his face after dua. He used to do this before he go to sleep. He will take his hand like this, understand, blow in it, and read Ikhlas, Falaq al-Nas, and he go over his head, his face, his body, front, back. So if the Prophet hold his hand, we hold our hand. If the Prophet ﷺ blow, we blow. If the Prophet did not, okay, we did not. Because we could not be a leader. We supposed to be a follower. What the Prophet do, he's our imam. How he do it, we do it, okay? So wipe in the face. Okay, last bid'ah, and is... I think China also tried to make some money from the Muslims. Now they invented something.
The counter?
No, this for the zikr. But I get you, this is something maybe you didn't hear about it. That something is the prayer rug itself, or you can even get it individually, you bought it.
Compass?
Huh?
Compass?
Not the compass. The compass is a means, is not a part of the deen itself. Bid'ah in the dunya is okay. Okay? But bid'ah in the deen, no. Okay, now they invented something that for you, if you make a mistake in your salah, so because every time you understand you're making how many sajda and how many rak'at is supposed to be, 4 rak'at for dhuhr. So if you go for number 5 or you go for 3 rak'at only, it will give you, understand, a signal, and how they commercialize it, I saw it on the internet. Say, you never have to worry about how many rak'at you pray. You never can mistake. You are never going to make a mistake in your salah again.
What is it on a prayer roll?
In the prayer roll is something that every understands that every time you go, I think it electronic. It will count how many, so it lets you know if you made a mistake or not. Subhanallah. We human, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam himself, he made a mistake. It shows you the mercy of Allah that you make a mistake not intentionally, and still Allah will accept your prayer and he give you the remedy how to correct it. Make two sajda sahu, and he said, no, never you will make salah again. Never you make a mistake in your salah, and this also is ibadah. All right, about saying because astaghfirullah, brother, from all the bid'ah, I'm coming to for astaghfirullah. If you don't have the book of Salah, Wudu and Salah by the Prophet, pray like the Prophet, or Wudu and Salah like the Prophet, you found there is a section called What to Say After Salah. There is a section, okay? It's a green book, 7th edition, by Sheikh Sayyid Ali. Okay, alright. You found a section about dhikr after Salah, and you should learn it. All these things is good, from saying Allahumma anta salam wa minka salam, astaghfirullah 3 times, subhanallah 33, alhamdulillah 33, Allah. All these things is sunnah, but making collectively is bid'ah. Okay? Or raising the voice with it is bid'ah. So we have to distinguish. Yes.
I have the habit of saying
this. Okay? It is sunnah to say all the things that I recorded in the book, and you should learn it and say it, okay? And you end with La ilaha illallah, okay? But what is innovation is the imam to lead the followers. Or that the people do it collectively, or you do it with a loud voice, okay? And also using the dhikr beads, okay? Because in narration, that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam used to make it in his right hand. Come on, you could not concentrate for 33, one time like this, and one time like this, and one finger. This is 33, all right? So everything becomes beads, 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 beads. And if you go to the history of the dhikr beads, okay, it came from Hindus and came from...
Roman Catholics.
Yes, it's imitation.
Yeah.
But the Prophet ﷺ used to do it in his hand, and also he used to do it only on the right hand. And there is a narration, it may have a slight defect in it, in the Hunna Mustantiqat. That means your hand, okay, will be a witness for you in the day of judgment. But your dhikr beads is not going to come there.
I never read it as of yet that he picked up stones and
no.
pebbles.
No. This is something that the people made it up so they can insert or invent and add to the deen of Allah. Okay, Muaz? So it's not correct. Alright? So, inshallah, we have to learn how to try to stick to the sunnah. Learn the sunnah. And when you see somebody doing bid'ah, try to be easy on them. Try to correct them nicely. Okay? We want to change the bid'ah to the sunnah according to the sunnah. Don't bust the people on their head. You understand? Or snatch the dhikr beads and say, astaghfirullah, brother, this is nicely. Because a lot of people, they don't know what is sunnah. They don't know about bid'ah. So we have to be gentle and kind and nice when we correct the people. Yes.
The place where you pray, if there is no prayer rug, but it should be clean. The place should not be dirty.
Akhi, you can pray on dirt, you can pray on mud, you can pray on grass, you can pray on asphalt.
No, I mean
it's nothing called no shed, no. Could not be impure. But about should, you understand? No. Nothing about this. You can pray about any surface that is tahir. This is it. Piece of carton, you understand? Piece of wood, you understand? But the earth itself, وَجُعِلَتْ لِيَ الْأَرْضُ مَسْجِدًا وَطَهُورًا. The Prophet ﷺ said, and the earth been made as a mosque for me. Earth means earth. So the earth, nothing wrong with the earth, okay? So when I say, okay, all right, so now let's get the mob, you understand? And no, what's wrong, okay? We can pray also with our shoes, all right? At least sometimes to practice the sunnah of the Prophet ﷺ. صَلُّوا فِينْ عَالِكُمْ, okay? The Prophet ﷺ said, pray in your shoes. And if the mosque is not carpet, okay, you supposed to do the sunnah that you look to your shoes before you enter. And if there is impurity in it, that you rub it in the ground. And after this, you can step with your shoes inside the mosque. This if the mosque is not carpeted, okay? Otherwise, by the time we pray Isha, because we practice sunnah, we're going to go, you understand, shampoo the mosque for $120. By Fajr, somebody else want to practice the sunnah, you understand, another hand. So we are not going to be collecting any money for electricity because we spend the money in cleaning the rug because somebody want to practice the sunnah. We practice the sunnah according to the sunnah. Okay? Any comments? Any questions? Okay, inshallah, we need some donation for tonight. Who would like to make some effort and try to convince to bring somebody with them, inshallah, for next class? This is your donation. This is two people. We have two people, three, four, five, six people. Alhamdulillah. Anybody going to make some effort? Zakallah khair. Seven. We can make some effort, nothing else. Thank you. Inshallah, put it in your Facebook, I mean Facebook, or whatever you call it, and encourage the Muslim to come spend 1 hour in the house of Allah. Fi baytillah. Zakallah. All right. Thank you very much. Exactly 1 hour. سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك نشهد أن لا إله